In this video, I am going to explain muscles that attach to ligament around pelvic girdle. You know, muscles attach to bone and bone. However, some muscles also attach to ligament. Why is this so important? What is function of ligament? Ligament connects bone and bone and that stabilize joint, correct? Then, muscle attaches to ligament. If these muscles get tight, that can directly inhibit movement of joint, don't you think? Then, I'm gonna start from this ligament. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. This one connects ischial tuberosity and sacrum like this. This is very thick and strong ligament. Three muscles attach to this ligament. First one is this one. This is biceps femoris. Biceps femoris. Next one is this one. This is semitendinosus. Semitendinosus. These two muscles are part of hamstrings, right? Semimembranosus doesn't attach to sacrotuberous ligament, but I think there is connection by myofascia. But its fiber doesn't attach to sacrotuberous ligament. What happens if these two muscles get tight? This tension can go to sacrotuberous ligament. Where is sacrotuberous ligament? Which bone does sacrotuberous ligament connect? That is ischium and sacrum. So tightness of hamstrings can create tightness for sacrum. Then this tightness can go up to lumbar spines, thoracic spines, and maybe all the way up to head, correct? And one visualization you can have is that you can visualize your hamstrings originate from sacrotuberous ligament. This visualization may help your athletic practice, or it can help your visualization of how you perceive your body. Let's say, anatomically, hamstrings originates from ischial tuberosity. But if you have vision that hamstrings originate from sacrotuberous ligament, or maybe you can have visualization that is from sacrum, however you want, then that may differentiate how you perceive body, then maybe your athletic ability increases. Having vision of anatomy is very important, right? So, biceps femoris and semitendinosus attaches to sacrotuberous ligament. I want to talk about one more muscle. One more muscle attaches to sacrotuberous ligament. That's this one. This is gluteus maximus, very famous muscle. Gluteus maximus. Imagine there's no gluteus maximus on right side. That attaches to sacrotuberous ligament around this area, right? So it's like hamstrings. When gluteus maximus gets tight, that may inhibit movement of sacrum, or that can go to hamstrings because gluteus maximus attaches to sacrotuberous ligament. Hamstrings also attaches to sacrotuberous ligament. No wonder there is connection between hamstrings and gluteus maximus. By the way, gluteus maximus has attachment to other fascia, other connective tissue. So this is very important muscle in terms of myofascial connection, connective tissue connection. Let me give you an example. gluteus maximus attaches to this fascia, this wide, white, shiny fascia. This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This is very broad fascia on low back. Again, when gluteus maximus gets tight, this can be cause for low back pain. See, gluteus maximus is important for myofascial connection, connective tissue connection. Anyway, sacrotibialis ligament has three muscle attachments: biceps femoris, semitendinosus, and gluteus maximus. Let's go to next ligament. Okay, next ligament is this one, this area. This is iliolumbar ligament. Iliolumbar ligament. One muscle attaches to this ligament. That's this one. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This muscle is freaking important for low back pain and tight low back. Look at its attachment. It attaches to iliac crest. This is pelvis. It attaches to transverse processes. These are lumbar spines. Then it attaches to 12th rib. This is part of rib cage. Additionally, that attaches to iliolumbar ligament. See how important this muscle is? When this muscle gets tight, no wonder that affects to low back pain and tight low back. I oftentimes focus to this muscle for tight low back and low back pain. Iliolumbar ligament and quadratus lumborum. Let's go to the last one. Okay, last one is quite famous. That's this ligament. This is inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament. This one connects ilium and pubis. Two muscles attach to this ligament. First one is this one, this core muscle. This is internal oblique. Internal oblique. Next one is this one. This is transverse abdominis. These muscles are both core muscle, right? I wonder why there's no external oblique. Anatomy books don't say external oblique attaches to inguinal ligament, but human body is different for everybody. So some people's external oblique may attach to inguinal ligament, correct? Why is this ligament so important? Let me give you one example. Posterior to inguinal ligament, muscles pass right here. This is iliopsoas. This is iliacus and this is psoas. These muscles are important for pelvic movement, lumbar movement, and hip movement. What happens if inguinal ligament gets tight here? That may affect both iliacus or psoas. Plus, nervous tissues and blood vessels pass to posterior to inguinal ligament. This area is so important in terms of nervous tissue thing, blood vessel things, and muscular system things. In this video, I explained three ligaments that have relationship with muscles. First one is this one. This is sacrotibialis ligament, right? Next one is iliolumbar ligament. Last one is inguinal ligament. I hope this video gives you a new idea to look anatomy from different angle. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.